Yaskawa. You're watching the IEC 61131 Basics video tutorial series. In this video, we'll make a custom user function. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier, and I'd like to explain the concept of creating a user function and then ask you to follow along with me through the steps of creating a simple function and implementing it in our project. So starting with the concept, what are we going for here? Is I would like us to make a function with the name ytts underscore temperature. And what will this function do? It will convert an analog input voltage to temperature. And we'll do that by using the equation y equals mx plus b, taking a multiplication of voltage times some scale factor to convert it from volts into, let's say, degrees, and then adding an offset, maybe negative or positive offset, to calibrate that to the right temperature. And you'll notice here, just from the beginning, that we're putting this prefix, ytts underscore. The reason we do that is as a best practice to avoid any name conflicts. It also helps with organization, because then whatever you choose for your prefix, all of those blocks will show up in the list together. And remember the property of functions. This applies also to our functions, that the output, a single output, will be calculated from these inputs in one scan. So when we're done, we will have a function that looks like this. YTTS temperature, we'll be able to drop it in from our own group in the edit wizard, which has the name of your project. There is a group there, you probably didn't notice it, but it's been there. And so our goal now is to create that code inside here and to correctly make that function. So where will we start in the software to create a function? Well, a function is one of the three types of POUs. So go to your logical POU. This is where you can insert functions and function blocks. For this video, we'll insert a function. When you insert a function, you're presented with this insert dialog. So let's refer to this page here. We're going to choose the name ytts underscore temperature, choose function. Let's write this one in ladder. And very important, something that we haven't done when we insert a program POU, is the data type of return value. It also says here the function name will be the var output. What's the function name? This is the function name. So our output will be called the name that we give the function. That's a really important point, and it applies only when you're making functions. So we'll choose the data type for it. Let's do that. So the name is ytts underscore temperature. It's a function, and I'll use ld. And it's tempting to just think you're done, and you forget to change the data type. Why did I choose lreal instead of real or integer? It just has to do with the hardware that you would expect to connect to this. I know in one of our products, we do have an analog input, and for whatever reason, that data type of that analog input is an lreal. And let's click OK. And you notice that it created the logical POU. And if you look real close at the icon, you'll see that there's a slight difference in the appearance, as it shows like a little mini function block with two inputs and one output. And then this little block doesn't show any inputs or outputs. This is the program POU icon, and this is the function POU icon. So let's open the code worksheet for this function. And the first thing that I'd like you to do is to try to create this code. You have a multiplication and an addition with three inputs, voltage, scale, and offset. All of these will be of lreal data type, and you'll be able to choose a usage now var input. These names will be the names that appear inside the function, that green function, when we insert it in our code later on. So let's do this much, and let's save the output here. I'll come back and mention the output again. Very important how you do the output so that you don't get a mistake. So now I'll demonstrate how to construct this user function. I would do it like this. We have a multiplication. And we have an addition. And I've noticed that I have the EN and ENO, which I don't need for this. So I could have done this before. I'll do it now. Insert blocks without EN, ENO. And then I just right click to update those. So we'll be multiplying and then adding together. And now for my inputs. My first will be the voltage. So we'll make a new one called voltage. Data type LReal. Usage var input. You can see we have the choice of var or var input when we're inside of a function. No var globals. Var input. Okay, voltage. Now I had one called scale. Remembers these here, LReal var input. And offset. LReal var input also. And now what about the output? If you double click here, you'll notice that there is no usage called var output for functions. Looking ahead to function blocks, there will be. We have a single output for functions. And if you remember when we defined the function, it said that the name of the function would be the output. And so the way to do this here is you go into the name column and the name should already be there. What you never want to do is try to type it in there and create another variable somehow with this name. That will completely confuse the issue, and I've seen people do that. So you want to choose it from the list, and you click OK here. So here it is. This is the function. The identity of the function is the result of this calculation based on the inputs. Okay, so that was the output. Now what's next? What do we do next to use this? Well, to use this, the first step is we need to make. Because what if you have an error in the way you've created this function? We need to have a successful make before we can start to use our block. Then after we make, we can take that function and open up another POU, such as main, and you'll add it as if you would have added any other block or any other instruction. We can add some variables to it. And then what about adding a program instance? You don't add a program instance for a function, because if you've added a function to the program already is running in one of the tasks. And so your function therefore runs in the operational order, the sequence, the execution order of whatever program POU you've chosen. Okay, so let's do a make. And I'm expecting some problems here. Okay, I have an error because I have, from my previous video, I had added many functions. Maybe you did the same. Let's just delete this stuff. This was just to experiment. I'm gonna double click on these errors and see how many I can find. Oh, there's another one. Just delete all these. For probable parameter not connected. Yeah, that's right. I think this one I'll just undo this duplicate by deleting it. There, now my and is back how it was before. And let's see if that helped. Okay, must have missed one. And here I should have had colon equal. Don't remember that happening. All right, so I've got zero errors now. I think I'll close these extraneous pages. And let's look just at YTTS temperature. And now the idea is that I will run this in another POU. Let's just run it in main. I always click no to the scaling information. Okay. And so now there's different ways to put a function to run in our POU. You could pull it in from the logical POUs list, like this. You could also pull it in from the edit wizard, find the name of your project, and you can pull it in this way. Or the short way is if you know the name, you type it. So I just want one of these. I think I'll delete the other two. And maybe I don't want the EN and ENO. Let's go to objects and right click to update this. And let's put some temporary variables here. I'll call it volt, scale, off, and an output here, maybe degrees. And of course now, this is a change to our code, so we'll need to make again. Okay, download changes maybe would have been a little quicker. I'll just download it here, download changes this way. Okay, and now I've got the block, and in debug mode, it's running, and I get this message about PowerFlow. What does PowerFlow mean? PowerFlow is a debug feature, and you'll get this message if you have a function worksheet open, because the functions would not be able to be monitored inside if it weren't for the PowerFlow feature. However, PowerFlow is more applicable to the ST, structured text language, so that you can monitor each line as it executes. And if you go into the F letter or FBD, the display will not be correct, and so it's not all that helpful. We'd recommend you just click no and don't use this feature of PowerFlow. So I'll click no, and all I wanted to do was to test this out. So I don't have available here any type of analog input for the simulator, so we will just have to assume that, and in some other PLC there is such a thing that has voltage in, and maybe I am seeing here 3.5 volts. I can overwrite that, and I could scale it by maybe there's a scale factor of 2. I'll keep the numbers easy just so we can show that it does work, and maybe I need an offset of 1.5, and so perhaps this voltage turns out to be 8.5 degrees. And so I hope you can see the concept here and the procedure for creating a function and using a function. Before we wrap it up, I'd like to look at the function properties, and there are ways to fix your function in case, for example, you didn't use the correct data type, or you made a function block instead of a function. So what you do here is just right click on the function. So out of debug mode, we can right click on our function and look at its properties. It will want you to close the tab that's open. And here we can see the name. You could update the name. You can also give a description. This description will appear in the edit wizard. And then here the tab for type allows you to take this POU and turn it into a function block or a program. And then also, if you missed that data type, if you're getting these errors complaining about the data types, it could be that the function has been assigned the wrong data type. The tabs for PLC processor can be left alone. Attributes can also be left. I guess you could hide it. I don't usually use that. And then security, if you are going to lock the project, you could, for every POU, you can apply the security of write or read protection. Okay, I made no changes, but I'll just leave that alone. To conclude, I'd like to leave you with this optional extra credit exercise. If you'd like some practice in the structured text language, why don't you create basically the same function? This one could be called force, or really it should be prefixed YTTS force, equals voltage times scale factor plus offset. You should be able to do this in one line of code using the correct IEC syntax. Remember F5 to declare each variable, and the semicolon at the end, and the colon equals here. You should be able to do this in one line. So if you'd like to try that, you may do so. So I'll go through that extra credit optional exercise here to make the force POU. I'll insert a function, YTTS underscore force. I'll use, in this case, structured text. I'd also like to work with LReal, and we'll follow this same procedure. I'll open it up, and now here we need to type the F5 key. In this case, I start on the left with the name of the function, yttsforce. The syntax is colon equals. I'll use a space to separate that, and F5 again. We wanted voltage as a var input plus another F5 here, scale factor, also as var input. I'm sorry, that was multiplied by the scale factor, added to F5 offset. Finish that with semicolon. Let's make it. All right, zero errors. Now in my edit wizard, I have both of these. And I could try it out in main. I think I'll just type it in, YTTS force, it comes right up. Maybe just for testing here, I will use the same group here with control click. Put those on there with a separate output called force. Now download changes. And that saved and compiled and downloaded my code. So I can close the resource, go into debug, click no to PowerFlow. And I can see that I also have a successful YTTS force, essentially the same function, but written in structured text. And this is the process for creating and using a function in Yaskawa's MotionWorks IEC.